All right, welcome back, everybody. Good to have you here for a little more Skyrim. We are... Well, I can't really say. I was going to say we're halfway up Hrothgar, but we're beyond that point at this stage in the game. We've basically... I'm pretty sure we've dismantled any opposition that we're going to encounter along the way. You can see the wind is really howling. You know what? I'm wondering what the hell has happened to my... You know, my cooking pot, my water skins, my torches, they don't seem to be popping up on my knapsack. Now, when I did swap sacks, it was in the middle of the horse inventory. I simply auto-equipped it. Let's take it off. And, wow, that's making a difference at this stage in the game. I'm carrying too much to be able to run at this point. So, this backpack, and it's 50 extra pounds of carry weight, making a difference. All right, there we go. Let's throw it on. And there we go. Now everything's loaded up properly. Good. You know, it's the little things, people. It's the little things that count. Okay. I think we're... I should do a quick check of my exposure. Yeah, it's... I'm not really feeling the effects up here. I was expecting it to be a little bit worse than it was. But, that's fine. That's fine. It plays a small factor. If it continues to, you know, just be non-existent... If the exposure rate is just not an issue whatsoever, I may increase the exposure rate ever so slightly in the mod options menu. Anyway, let's take a look at this next tablet. Number 6. With roaring tongues, the sky children conquer, of founding the first empire with sword and with voice, whilst the dragons withdrew from this world. Yes, so the dragons were finally chased away. Man had been taught by the divine Kinnereth, Kain, and Parthenax, on how to master the voice and use it against their oppressors, the dragon oppressors. Now, Parthenax, I'm pretty sure he is a dragon himself. Perhaps a traitor to his kind, I'm not sure. And here we go, number 7. Let's take a quick look at it. The tongues of Red Mountain went away humbled. Jurgen Windcaller began his 7-year meditation to understand how strong voices could fail. Yes. And the whole Jurgen Windcaller bit of lore, I think I'm just going to leave that. I used to know it quite well. It was a kind of a minor, before Skyrim, it was a minor little piece of lore. But it's very much, very prominent now in the retelling of this tale, or the creation of this tale. Jurgen Windcaller chose silence and returned. The 17 disputants could not shout him down. Jurgen the Calm built his home on the throat of the world. And that's where we are right now. We're arriving there quite shortly. And the way I remember the lore was that Jurgen was had such a powerful thume that he basically, I think he just swallowed the shouts of all the other men that were, and for like 7 days. I can't remember how it goes exactly, how the little tale went. But it was something like that. Alright, and you can see we've got Shrine of Talos here. For years all silent, the Greybeards spoke one name. Tiber Septim, Stripling then, was summoned to Hrothgar. They blessed and named him Dovahkiin. Dovahkiin. Yes. Beautiful. And of course, Tiber Septim, being Talos himself. And the final stone tablet. The voices worship, follow the inner path, speak only in true need. Yes. Use it for good, kind of. Voice of the Sky added. I wonder what that is, exactly. Let's take a look. Oh, I've got a little bone break fever. I wonder where I got that. Stamina minus 30. Must have been... Was it the bear at the bottom of the mountain? Possible. I think maybe that could be where it came from. I'm also tired. Anyway. What do I have here? Voice of the Sky lasting for 23 hours. Animals will neither attack nor flee from you. That's not bad. That's not bad. Okay. Let's drop these supplies off for old Klimek. Where are they exactly? Perfect. And I guess maybe he'll... You know what? He may, just out of kindness, out of gratitude, offer me a small reward. and I'll throw it on the ground. I want no... You know, I offered to do it for free. Obviously, I don't think I can actually do that, but... We'll imagine Rogar did. No, sir, I don't want your gold. Consider it a favor done by the Dovahkiin of Nu. Yes. Okay, here we go.
So, a dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age.
You call me dragonborn, but what does this mean?
First, let us see if you truly are dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice.
Very well. Oh, you don't want to taste it, sir. You don't want to taste it. I think I need to, get it. Oh, I have it selected. Good. Y'all want some
Shout
of this, dude. Very
Let
good.
Taste of your voice.
Very good, Ongar. Very good, Christopher Plummer. I will oblige you, sir.
Dragonborn, it is you.
It is.
Welcome to High Hrothgar. I am Master Angir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn.
Yes?
Why have you come here?
I want to understand. Let me see. No, I want to understand what it means to be the Dragonborn.
We are here to guide you in that pursuit. Just as the Greybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you.
You mean I'm not the only one?
You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind. Whether you are the only dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say.
There can be only one. Yes, as I go Highlander on the rest of them. You know, trekking across all of Tamriel, Slaughter, and any who may be competition to the Dovahkiin. Anyway, no, Rogard would never do such a thing. I'm ready to learn, Christopher Plummer, yes.
You have shown that you are Dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you? That remains to be seen.
Oh, just take
Without
my word
training,
for it, I do.
You have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice into a thum, a shout. Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn. When you shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Ro, the second word in Unrelenting Force. Ro means balance in the dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thumb more sharply.
Ro! You truly are wise, Christopher Plummer. Good. God damn, man carved that in with his voice. Curve that into the floor with his voice. All right, what am I doing here? Oh, there we go. Who's roll? Who's roll?
You work like a monster.
Oh, thank you.
You truly do have the gift.
Was
but
there ever any doubt?
The word of power is only the first step. You must unlock its meaning through constant practice in order to use it in a shout. Well, that is how the rest of us learn shouts. As Dragonborn, you can absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Ro.
What's this guy's name again? I keep missing it. Einarth.
Now, let us see how quickly you can master your new thumb.
Y'all want some more of this, do ya? All right, people.
Use your unrelenting force shout to strike the targets as they appear.
Oh, okay.
Vixosa!
Hoya! Oh, damn. Got a nice little echo on that sucker. Who's next?
Well done.
Thank you, Christopher Plummer. Again? Bye. Watch yourself over there. I guess I have to wait for it to finish recharging itself. Awkward pause, Christopher. Yes.
Once more.
God.
Impressive.
I know.
Your thumb is precise.
That's what she
said.
Great
promise, Dragon.
What? I don't know. Listen, Christopher Plummer, I've been shouting since I was a boy.
Next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori.
All right, Bori. Show the way, sir. Didn't mean to make a mess of the place, people. It's not like they get many visitors. They don't really have to keep a clean castle, you know? And they're certainly in no rush, you know? Despite dragons being loosed, Alduin on the world, or Alduin, his terror unleashed upon the world, Bori here taking his sweet-ass time. You don't rush things when you're a Greybeard, yes. You don't rush things either when you've, you know, when you're as revered an actor as Christopher Plummer, yes. All right, Bori.
You will now see how you learn a completely new shout. Master Bori will teach you Wold, which means whirlwind.
Wold.
All right.
You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thumb.
Good. Let me walk over this then. Oh, fantastic.
Approach Master Wold and he will gift you his knowledge of Wold.
And a thank you, kind sir. Yes, give a little bow to him.
Now we will see how quickly you can master a new shout. Master Wolfgar will demonstrate whirlwind sprint. Then it will be your turn. Master Bori?
X! Wolf!
Now, your turn.
All right, well, is the goddamn thing even selected? I don't even know. Let me see.
Stand next to me.
Yes?
Master Bori will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes.
Oh, well, very well.
Hold!
Hoya! What's he saying? Hold! Hold! Good. I'm gonna go back and talk to Wolfgar. No. What the hell was that? Oh no, I need to go talk to. Why am I all weighted down now? I'm not sure.
Quick mastery of a new thumb is astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself.
I don't know, Arngeir. I don't know Christopher Plummer. I've been doing this, like I said, since I was a boy. That's why I got the name Windmaker. And I thought it was as easy as this for everyone else, yes.
No, indeed not. But beware that your skill does not outstrip your wisdom. You are now ready for your last trial.
Good.
Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengrav. Remain true to the way of the voice, and you will return.
Fantastic. I will try and do this honor justice, sir. And let's see. Any info that I can get here from Christopher Plummer? I just like saying his name. Let's inquire about old Jürgen Windcaller here.
He was a great war leader of the ancient Nords, a master of the voice or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, he spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat. He finally came to realize that the gods had punished the Nords for their arrogant and blasphemous misuse of the voice.
Gods do like to do that.
He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not the glory of men. Jürgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition. and the way of the voice was born.
Oh. Christopher Plummer, tell me, what is this way of the voice you speak of?
The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do. Although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship and glory of the gods. True mastery of the voice can only be achieved when your inner spirit is in harmony with your outward actions. In the contemplation of the sky, Kinnereth's domain, and the practice of the voice, we strive to achieve this balance.
Respectable. I will try to follow the way of the voice.
That is commendable. But remember, the dragon blood is itself a gift of Akatosh. Do not try to deny that gift. Your destiny requires you to use your voice. Why else would Akatosh have bestowed this power upon you? If you remember to use your voice in service to the purpose of Akatosh, you will remain true to the way.
Good. And, I think that's probably all I'm gonna chat it up with old Chris Plummer here for the time being. Yes.
Breath and focus.
Okay, people. Well, Arorgard, at this point, he needs some rest. For some reason now... The other thing I forgot to do... You know, we went in and we looked at the fact that I have... I have this disease, bone break fever. Oh, there we go. Carry weight minus 50. So you can see, I think this is the first time we're really accurately seeing... one of these diseases... which are made more intense... With realistic needs and diseases mods... Or the R&D mod, okay, the realistic needs and diseases mod. You can see how it now advances through stages and becomes more severe, you know, almost crippling at this point, you know. So let's cure this up. Hawk feather, I think, is the way I have to go. I don't think I have a potion of cure disease at the ready. And there we go. Fantastic. So we met up with the Greybeards. I don't think they actually allow me... Oh, I'm still carrying too much. Are you kidding me? It must be because I'm so bloody tired right now. Very tired, yes. Carry weight is down to 60. I don't think they actually allow me a bed. And I don't even know if I can camp out here. Probably not. It's probably sacred goddamn ground or something. Let's take a look, though. Oh, I can. That is fantastic. Well, that's where we're setting up right here. I guess it's a sacred ground. Sacred and reserved for the Dovahkiin, yes, upon his arrival. Oh, who's this now? Oh, it's Christopher Plummer. No, sir, not tonight. I don't swing that way anyway, Chris. My apologies, sir. Alright, anyway, I don't know. That was filthy. That was filthy and unneeded. Filthy and unneeded, okay. What do I want to do now? I guess we're going to, I'll see you all in the morning or after we get Rorgard a little rest here. Alright, people, welcome back. Or, well, it's not really morning. I bedded him down at about 5 o'clock in the morning. Slept for 8 hours. What we're going to do now is we're going to go down this mountain. I'm going to level up, I think. We'll pack up the camp. I've got quite a bit of food that's actually starting to turn on me here. Let's take a look at that. Well, I better not litter out here. It's the sacred ground. I was just going to drop it all over the place. But at long last, or not at really at long last, but I've pretty well dealt with all the negative effects that were coming my way. Cooked up a little meat. Turned some of my boiled water just into plain water. And what I want to do is I want to do a little leveling up. I would imagine I've got at least one perk available coming my way. Oh, I could have... Actually, I could have two. I think perhaps I do. Let's get this health rolling. No, just the one. Just the one. What are we going to go with? What are we going to go with? I could hop back in on this light armor. Let's see here. What is that weak spot exactly? Oh, I hate this. Trying to get to the one you want. There. You deal 10% more damage with all weapons against any enemy that only wears the light armor. I don't know about that. Alright, I wouldn't mind checking out the next node on the marksmanship tree. Keen's Lance. So while wielding a longbow, you gain a damage bonus against faraway targets, a 10% for a range of at least 40 feet, 20% for a range of at least 70 feet, and 30% range, or 30% for a range of at least 100 feet. That could be good. I'm terrible at judging in distance like that, though, in measurements of in real life, too, you know, not just in some video game. I'm terrible at assessing stuff like that. Anyway, so I think I may leave that for the time being. Light weaponry. Now, we did have a little success with that dual flurry, or not the dual flurry, but the dual wielding, and there is this, I can't get to it. It just skips right over it. Son of a... Anyway, dual wielding attacks are 20% faster and deal 10% less damage. And deal... What? That makes no sense. 10%... Maybe it does make sense. If they're coming in 20% faster, perhaps there's... It could be deal 10% less damage, or it could be intended that it should say more damage. That would make sense. It could be that it costs 10% less stamina per attack. I don't know. I'm not really sure. Okay, I got the strong grip. There was something over here, critical charge. I can do a one-handed power attack while sprinting that does double critical damage. I should take a look at the block category. Now, I did get one here, I think. Yes, I did. Blocking is 40% more effective if I take the next one. What I'd like is one that lessens the amount of... lessens the amount of stamina it costs, you know. Just taking a look around. I should find something here. I guess I did spend a little time at the alchemy table. That could be an ideal selection. Let's see. So I could opt to make them another 10% stronger. Or I could try and focus on making my poisons a little bit more effective, 20% more effective, or just focus on my health. You know what? Anything that is going to restore health, magic, or stamina, 25% more powerful. I have a feeling that could be a really great way to go here. And I think that's what I'm going to do, because I think of all the kind of the crafting from the, the forge work to the alchemy table, I think Rogard will be more adept at mixing potions than anything else, you know? He'll have a basic understanding. He'll do a little work at the forge when needed. But his real skill lies with the potions, or at least that's what I'm hoping for. Okay, let's go to the world map and let's take a look around. I have a feeling we're probably at about 25 minutes as it stands. So the episode getting a little long. This is the Palace of the Kings. That's the next mission for... Well, I have to actually return there to get the mission from Galmar. That's for the Stormcloak quest line. And, where is... Okay, I guess I can remove the marker. What I want is the... Where was he sending me? Ostengraf. That's where I need to get to. That's for, the Horn of Jürgen Windcaller. What I think I'm going to do is make my way back to Windhelm. Yes, I think that's probably a good choice. We'll get that mission. We'll do it. And then we'll head over towards Ustengraf and do that as well. And Rogard, a little bit more powerful at this point. You know? That he's got the second word learned for his Fus Ro Dah. Actually, I now have three shouts available at my disposal. So, I need to favorite up the Whirlwind Sprint as well. I just love the sound of that echo. I'm pretty sure the echo is coming in with this mod I have attached to the game, or I have running with the game right now, called Thundering Shouts. Yeah, I think that's what's causing that. And it actually sounds really good. I like it. But people, you know what? I think I'm going to have to wrap it right there. I'm almost positive we're running a little bit long. So the journey back down the mountain begins. Shouldn't be too much of an effort to get back down there. And we'll hop on the horse at Irestead. and set off towards Windhelm once more, and, you know what, continue to work our way through the Stormcloak ranks, gaining respect, honor, dignity as we go, and, you know, hopefully tipping the civil war in their favor when it's all said, before it's all said and done, right? Anyway, I do have to wrap it, so until next time, all, remember why it hurts.
First, no!
Later.